kid that day you hate. The little black boy with no swag who wore his shoes without no laces. But now I'm getting P and getting famous. So you can keep your feet.
Come on! John?
Marshal?
Gentlemen! It's time. We must go.
Why? What's happening?
Seth has managed to get himself inside. But we can't leave it too long, or they will soon realize how very curious he is and remove him from the premises. Or slit his throat and watch him bleed to death. But for a minute, he will delight and amuse them. That's when he'll get us inside.
Okay.
Marshals of the law, when the shooting starts, take that as your cue to start awarding each other medals.
Huh?
I mean, take that as a cue to get inside and clean up the mess.
Oh.
All I care about is Williamson. It is vital we stop him.
Agreed. That man is a stone-cold killer.
Williamson's a proud fool. The question is which will win out between his pride and his instinct for survival.
Ensconce yourself in the back of my wagon, John, so that we can make our grand entrance.
Come on, let's go.
All right, good. Now just stay put till I tell you otherwise. That scoundrel Seth had better not let us down. Once we're inside and I've lulled our adversaries into a false sense of security with some beguiling sales patter, I will give you the signal.
What signal?
The moment you hear a sharp rap on the side of the wagon, rise like the phoenix and start shooting like you've never shot before. This is it, my dear boy. The moment of truth. Me and you, John. One last time into the breach. This is going to have to be the performance of my life. I hope my nerves don't get the better of me. I'll be honest with you, John. I'm a little jittery. John? John?
It reeks of miracles back here.
Thank God. Now I'll be ready with that machine gun, my dear boy. I'll be a sitting duck in there. My good men, what would you say if I said immortality was at hand? What would you say if I told you I could teach you to fly? What would you say if I told you I could turn a man into a beautiful woman? Impossible, yes, once, but no more. Gentlemen, I bring you wisdom from the East. I have here in this wagon some of the finest goods, the best medicines, and the newest inventions available for you and your families. Exotic trinkets from the far reaches of the earth, elixirs that give vigor and strength. And for you men of physical skill and athletic physique, this miraculous elixir can keep the muscles supple and relax the cords. It loosens the joints and gives a feeling of vigor and freshness to the whole system. Why, some men have reported to me that after drinking it for 1 month, they can chew through steel.
What the hell?
It's a trap!
Get your thumb.
I ain't gonna lie to you, boy.
That's never been true!
dang pig. Them cocksucking sumbitches escaped the other side of the fort.
All right, let's go.
Come on, let's go.
I think my work here is done. Gun?
Give it to stay with me. Damn you.
You're making a big mistake, friend.
Let's keep moving.
I think my work here is done. Godspeed, gentlemen. I bid you
with the
fool. I ain't gonna make
you. You think you're tough guys, do you?
That's the last of them. We still can't find Williamson anywhere.
Hey, it's the snake oil guy!
General Adam, let me in, for goodness sake!
That fool must be hiding.
Men, it is time to start tearing this place apart and find out where he's cowering!
You've got a sense of urgency here, please!
Open the gate! It's the snake oil guy!
Get the goddamn gate open and lock it behind him!
Oh, we've got company, gentlemen. These scoundrels have got reinforcements riding this way.
Oh, my good Lord above. There must be 100 of them.
Things are about to get really messy.
Come on, come on, come on, come on. Bill ain't here. We looked everywhere.
Hold on! Oh, darn, I've missed it.
Mr. Marston, we got a live one. He says, Bill's already run off to Mexico yesterday morning.
You'll never get him.
Javier Escuela. He's gone to see Javier Escuela. That should make things interesting. Where in Mexico?
How should I know?
Oh! Where in Mexico, you little shit?
Someplace near Chuparos, I think he said. That's bandit country.
Chupa feckin' Rosa. Well, I'll take you there, John. I'm real popular down there. You just meet me at the ferry. I've got lots of friends down south.
I'll see you at the ferry, Irish.
I'll just get me things.
I'm sorry about this, John. I guess you'll be heading to Mexico.
So it would seem. How is it down there?
Wonderful. A sweet, peace-loving people with the love of social justice. May you always find coin in your pocket. It's been a pleasure spending time with you, boy.
You too, Mr. West Dickens. Marshall?
All right, boys. That's enough.
Something don't feel right here.
Yes, well, that's what makes you such an interesting fellow, Mr. Irish. Ah, Mr. Marston, I've come to wish you well. How are you, sir?
I'm okay.
It seems that our friend Mr. Irish here is well connected south of the border.
Oh, it's true. They love me down there. It's like a second home. I've got more friends than you could shake a stick at, should you so desire.
So you know the way?
Oh, it's easy. We just get on me raft here and let the current sweep us away to paradise. Come on then, Dobby.
I'm not sure your idea of paradise and mine are quite the same, Irish.
Relax. We'll have a great time and we'll find your man Williamson, no bother.
I hope so.
Hey, come on now. Look at it this way. I know we ain't exactly old pals, but, you know, have I ever done you wrong?
No. But not through lack of trying.
Hey!
Well, you boys have fun down there. I shall miss you, John Marston.
Thank you. Where are you headed?
Oh, me? Oh, London or Paris or maybe Peking. I'm a traveling man, sir. This land is much too small for the likes of me.
Well, try not to get yourself killed.
Oh, well, yes, we men of science are not a very loved bunch in this land of myth and superstition. I'm off to the civilized world, where men like myself are revered and given medals.
Ha!
Have fun.
The same to you, sir. The same to you.
Nice of you to turn up for once, Irish.
What do you mean?
In usual fashion, you conveniently missed all the action at Fort Mercer.
What can I say? I woke up with me head in a pair of tits, and it felt ill-mannered not to get reacquainted with him.
At least you got your priorities straight.
You know me, Johnny boy. I'll be late to me own funeral. They say God invented whiskey to stop the Irish from ruling the world. Jesus, they're shooting at us!
Cut the rope, Irish! We're sitting ducks here!
Well, I'll be bucking backwards. Ain't you got some peckers to be sucking? Man, this fella's got a nasty grudge. It was only a little. All right, I'll beach this floating tinderbox once we lose these sons of bitches. I stashed some ammunition near the back of the raft. Grab it if you're running low.
one dead body here in Claire!
I don't care how many of you there are!
Welcome to Mexico, Johnny boy! Makes Austin look like Buckingham Palace! Look out for those two fellow under horses! Sakes alive! I'm warning you! Set the hell down! For the love of God!
You should run off home!
Bloody Nara! Kill these ungrateful bastards, man! Look left, on top of the cliff. I'd give up now if I were you. That's the feller.
Run away, pal.
Shite him.
This ain't exactly the reception I was expecting.
They're not ones to forgive and forget, these fellas. Go to hell, you dumb puddling bastards.
What the hell'd you do to these fellas?
I recall it was something to do with money, and possibly some misunderstanding about a fella's daughter, but the details escaped. Stinking sons of trumpets!
Don't make me kill you!
Got your handle on you! Open it!
Come on now!
Get the hell away from me! I came into this trial disappointed, and I'll go out of it.
I expect you.
There's the bastard. More the bastards!
Get West in bed!
You ain't getting another penny out of me!
This ain't exactly the reception I was expecting.
They're not ones to forgive and forget, these fellas. You got it all wrong, it wasn't me!
What the hell did you do to these fellas?
I thought it was something to do with money, and possibly some misunderstanding about a fella's daughter, but the details escaped. You must be taking up another Irish fella! Well, I'll be coming backwards.
One of you go get some bread! Even this up a bit!
Oh, my good lord! Them up on the cliff to the left.
You try it.
I'm warning you. Set the hell down. There's the idiot.
You're dead, friend. This
This ain't exactly the reception I was expecting.
They're not going to forgive and forget these fellas.
Put your hand up, idiot!
What the hell did you do to these fellas?
I recall it was something to do with the possibly a misunderstanding about but the details escaped. Go to hell, you dumbfounded bastard!
Go home, buddy!
Vámonos, idiota! Por ahí no, vamos aquí!
For the love of God! Think you got some peckers to... You must be thinking of another Irish guy.
I expect.
On top of the cliff.
Sneaking tons of trumpets.
It's gonna take more than one of you, partner. Exactly the reception I was expecting.
They're not ones to forgive and forget, these fellas.
Damn,
down, chasers!
What the hell did you do to these fellas?
I recall it was something to do with money, and possibly some misunderstanding about the mayor's daughter, but the details escaped me.
It's you or me, friend!
That's the villain! I've warned you! Get the hell down! Bloody Nara! I want that money fair and square!
You must have a real bad death wish!
And I'm covered backwards.
Come on, then!
I came into this while fighting, and I'll go out of it fighting.
I expect you'll go out of it pissing your pants.
Oh, my good lord! You ain't getting another penny out of me!
This is the fourth time your so-called friends have nearly got me killed. I thought you said they loved you over here.
They do. At least the lassies do. Oh, them big brown eyes. Turn stone into butter, they would. And the Mexicans know how to make a bottle of liquor, too. What, that pulque? Now, that's a drink as would take the frost out of a frosty morning. Oh, you're gonna have some fun.
I'm just here for Bill Williamson.
Well, I'm glad to be back. This place is a wild devil's paradise.
Apart from the fellas trying to kill you.
Down here, they call me El Rato, the cat, on account of his stealth and cunning.
I'm pretty sure Rato means rat, my friend. I like it, though. A little more inventive than Irish.
Well, you Americans never were very creative with your use of language, was you, John Marston? They're still coming! Behind that big rock! Nobody shoots at me!
Stop shooting at me! I haven't stepped foot in this country in their own.
They'll insist on fraternizing with the notorious Irish outlaw.
Why do you want to die?
these ungrateful bastards, men!
Look out, fellas! They're on top of the
cliff! Take the gun away from me!
That's enough, my friend!
Damn murder, sons of bitches! By that rock! Stamp down, chaser!
I thought we were friends!
I'd give up now if I was you!
Just drop the gun! It ain't worth it!
I haven't stepped foot in this country, and they're already trying to kill me.
I will insist on fraternizing with a notorious Irish outlaw.
I want that money fair and square! Oh, I see you.
Tell me. You must have been called it a few times.
Look there, on top of the cliff.
Anybody else?
There's the idiot.
This is where it is, buddy.
Come
right
on,
here.
Man, friends here, friends.
So much for your damn connections, Irish.
I told you they knew me in Mexico, didn't I? Bloody Nara!
Look up, Pillar! They're on top of the cliff!
You must be taking a murder!
Down the lot of you!
I'll miss these escapades, Johnny boy, I really will.
I doubt you'll remember any of it, Irish.
I see that. The current should put us ashore up ahead. Heads up! There's two more! We made it, thank the Lord. Am I glad to be getting out of that floating death trap.
Oh, these horses look fresher! And healthy!
Before you degrade these poor fools any further, tell me where I'm headed.
Of course, of course. Let me think.
You do know people down here, aside from your friends who welcomed us on the way.
Yes, I think so. I was real drunk last time I was here, John. You know how it is. I met an American guy, saw him shoot a man, drank with him in the village of Chuparosa. Funny guy. Or was that Canada? No, that was Canada. Guy here, not funny, but he's real nice. Failing that, you could try the provincial governor, Colonel something or other. Some Spanish name. He's based out of Escalera. Played three-card stud with him. Or was it four-card Monty? I forget. He was a real nice chap. Or maybe he was a real bastard. I was real drunk last time, John.
Well, thanks a lot for your help. Oh, let me guess. You gotta be on your way.
The famed hospitality isn't what it once was, and I've never been known to overstay me welcome. So off I go to greener pastures. Good luck, John. You're an angry and a feck ugly man, but not a bad one.
¿Qué pasó con el otro?
No interrumpas, pendejo, deja en la casa. Y les digo, de aquí para acá, chingan a su madre. ¿Qué? No, ¡cállese, güey! Y de aquí para acá, son pendejos.
¡Ey, gringo! ¿Hablas español?
No, sir. Pardon, pero yo hablo un solo poquito español.
Poquito.
¿Habla inglés?
Oh, sí, gringo. Hablo mucho inglés.
Sí.
Hablo filthy fucking bean eater. Hablo slippery little Mexican. Oh. Hablo little piece of shit.
Shit.
¿Comprende, amigo? ¿Comprende? Hey, what are you doing here, gringo? I don't remember inviting you to my country.
I don't think you did, amigo. I mean you no harm.
You mean us no harm? This is funny. What harm could you do to us exactly?
Nothing, amigo. Now, I appreciate the welcome committee, but I'd hate to spoil a beautiful afternoon on such beautiful land with any further unpleasantries. If you'll excuse me.
Hold it, gringo. I think you're forgetting something. A little taxation. I have a large family.
Very big.
I, too, have a family friend. So that we may see our families again, I suggest we part ways amicably.
Can I see the boots, gringo?
I think you can see him from where you're standing just fine, senor.
Take off the boots, Americano.
As you wish.
Oh, very good. Very good indeed, sir. What a great way to improve border relations. An illiterate farmer crossing the river, coming into their civilization and butchering the local peasants. Thank you very much, sir.
Don't mention it, old man.
You kill peasants, you become a peasant.
I never aspired to be anything more.
A socialist, huh? No wonder you left America.
Not many things. Most of them bad. But a man of political principles? No.
Well, then I fear Mexico may not be for you, sir.
Don't you worry about me.
Oh, but I do worry. An angry man a long way from home, a man who handles a gun as sloppy as you.
I can handle a gun okay, partner.
Yeah, as long as you're killing quail or peasants. But if you have to face another man, you don't stand a chance.
And you do?
I can show you a few tricks. Come with me.
Hold on. What's your name?
That doesn't matter anymore. And you?
I never had a name, mister. I was raised in an orphanage.
A real American, huh? Wonderful. Just wonderful. Well, you won't make it in the circus, but you can shoot. Keep on practicing.
Thank you, old man.
Now, who are you?
No one interesting. Who are you?
Landon Ricketts. Not a name that means much anymore.
It means a little. You were famous when I was a boy.
Yeah, killing men's a strange kind of fame. I was the fastest in my time. I must have been. I'm the only one left.
What are you doing here?
Living quietly. Waiting.
For what?
I don't know. And you?
I'm looking for a couple of men. Bill Williamson, Javier Escuela. Escuela's from here.
It could be. This whole place is teeming with Americans on the run. Mercenaries, locals hell-bent on revolution.
Revolution? Another one?
Yeah. Never really ends. This whole place has been a hotbed for revolution since before the Spanish left. Now there's another local guy running around promising the peasants their freedom. Ah, just like the last two or three. Local government, foul bunch. Colonel Allende, he runs this place like a feudal king. He's an awful individual.
Is that so?
Yeah. Until someone puts a bullet in his head. Well, let's get back to it. You gotta keep that back straight. Otherwise, it makes the gun jump. See if this Schofield makes a difference. Now that's a real gun.
Desgraciado! Carajo, gringo! No te da pena!
Stay with it. You can do this. Make sure you hit every bottle.
Basta! Malísimo! Disparas como una niña!
All right, let's go again. Concentrate on all three bottles at the same time. Well done. Now that wasn't so hard, was it? Come on, I've got another idea. The birds around here are always raising hell, scavenging and scaring the life out of the locals. I say we put your newfound skills to the test while doing a public service for the good people of Chuparosa. Here we'll do. I'm gonna scare up some birds. Let's see if you can take down more than one at a time. Sir, you've been taught well.
Señor Ricketts! Señor Ricketts!
Señor Ricketts! Señor Ricketts! Por favor, señor. Our back wagon's under attack just outside of town. We need your help again.
Whoa, slow down, Ramon. We'll take care of it.
Thank you, señor. Again, you are the savior of this town.
Well, my friend, are you ready to take a less theoretical exam?
Sure.
I don't think I ever rode with no savior before.
Let's haul out. Time we put you to work on some bigger prey. Look over there. They're in trouble, all right? Come on.
That's too damn close!
salvaron la vida.
Keep your eyes peeled. These bandits don't give up.
Come on. I can see you haven't lost your touch, Landon.
Nobody said I had. You talk real big for a boy who couldn't shoot straight a half hour ago.
And you talk big for an old man who can't stand up straight no more.
You're a long way from being a Landon Ricketts partner, young, old, or otherwise.
John Marston! So much for this quiet life of yours, Mr. Ricketts.
I didn't say I'd become a coward. I'm not gonna stand by and watch these people suffer.
They don't know how lucky they are.
Sano y salvo. Nunca podré agradecer lo suficiente.
Buy me a whiskey later, and we'll call things about even.